Listen as your day unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try to keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard. You gotta be tough. You gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool. You gotta be calm. You gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. Hear what your mother said. Read the books your father read. Try to solve the puzzles in your own sweet time. Some may have more cash than you. Others take a different view. My, oh my. Yeah, 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 yeah. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough. You gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm. You gotta stick together. All I know is love will save the day. Time asks no questions, it goes on without you. Leaving you behind if you can't stand the pace. The world keeps on spinning, can't stop it if you try to. This time it's danger staring you in the face. Listen as your day unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try to keep your head up to the sky. Yeah, those lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. My, oh my. Yeah, 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 yeah. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough. You gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm. You gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day. Yeah, yeah. You gotta be bad, you gotta be bold, you gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard, you gotta be tough, you gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool, you gotta be calm, you gotta stay together. All I know is love will save the day.
Thank you. Thank you. Love will save the day. Good morning, everybody. How are you all doing this morning? Good. Who was here with me last night for the concert? Yes. Next year, all hands up. I swear. It was my first time, and I had such a peaceful, healing experience. The sound of the trio together was just heaven. So I hope to see you all there next year. We had a blast. Let's go ahead and wave hello to our friends online. We're getting to that time of year where we're going to see more of our friends in-house going online, and we want to make sure we still send them love. So thank you so much for tuning in. Like, subscribe, share, and stay on the journey with us. And make sure you silence your cell phones so we can be present. I had to silence mine so we can all do it. I promise we can disconnect. And now let's rise on up. Let's wake up our sleepy bones from daylight savings time. We lost an hour. Come on, let's do it.
Woke up this morning with my mind set on spirit. Woke up this morning with my mind set on spirit. Woke up this morning with my mind, yeah, set on spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Walking and talking. Walking and talking with my mind set on spirit. Walking and talking. my mind. Set on spirit, walking and talking with my mind. Set on spirit, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yeah, let me see it. Woke up this morning with my mind.
Oh, yeah.
Woo, set.
This thing.
Oh, we have fun here. Oh my goodness. So let me introduce you to our little trio this morning of music wonderment. We have Jesse on guitar. Brian Jones on the drums. And my name is Amy. I'm so happy to be with you this morning. And now, more fun than you could ever know, I get to introduce to you the bundle of joy that is Suzanne Soul.
I'm going to put bundle of joy on my business cards. Whoa. Good morning, Unity. I am Suzanne Soul, and it is my absolute joy, bundle of joy, to be your host today. I just love Unity. We were just talking earlier. My friend Jesse was saying how just being here this morning helped him feel grounded, and I feel that same experience, you know, but it's in such a light and wonderful way, and I feel such a beautiful connection with my spiritual family here at Unity, and it is my absolute delight to come here and be a part of this service today, so thank you. I would like to invite any newcomers or first-time visitors to stand if you're comfortable. And we just want to recognize and welcome you. Anyone? Hey, 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 girl! Thank you. Thank you so much for standing and letting us know you're here. As always, I invite the community to say this with me to our guests, whoever you are and wherever you are on your spiritual journey, you are welcome here. So all newcomers are invited to the Welcome Center in the Breezeway outside after service for a special gift from all of us at Unity of Naples. A few announcements for you this morning. All active Unity of Naples members are invited to join us for our annual meeting following service today. We will be revealing the results of our recent board elections and delivering reports from spiritual leadership, operations, and finances. We look forward to seeing you right back here in the sanctuary. Don't miss our new community day, game day hosted by Higher Grounds this Thursday from 1 to 3 p.m. Woo, woo, woo! Yes, yes! We'll have a variety of card and board games available, but feel free to bring your favorites along, like Monopoly. Not enough time for Monopoly. Sorry. Snacks and drinks will be available for $5 per person. Join us for the Naples Arts and Crafts Festival this Saturday. This event brings together artists, crafters, and enthusiasts in a celebration of creativity and culture across a wide range of mediums. Also featuring plein air artistry, with artists creating their own works throughout the day. And finally, March 21st, join Rev. Mark Fuss for a joyful Sunday service. Rev. Mark serves as Vice President of Outreach and Engagement for Unity World Headquarters as Mayor of the Town of Unity Village. Join us after service for a Q&A session and an opportunity to hear all about the exciting things happening at Unity World Headquarters and Unity Village. Keep going. Our theme for 2024 is Practical Tools for Spiritual Living. Our March theme is The Power of Insight. And today's message is entitled Inner Knowing by licensed Unity teacher Jeannine Hedberg. And so now I invite all of you to stand up and join in with me as we recite our current vision and mission statements. Please say with me our vision. We are co-creating a world that recognizes our wholeness as individuals and our oneness as humanity. In our mission, we inspire and nurture each other to awaken to the truth of who we are, the embodiment and expression of love. Please stay standing and take a moment to greet your neighbors with love this morning.
Please sit down, sit down. And let's just take a deep breath together as a community and claim the truth that Amy and Jesse just sang. We know that we are one. We know that we are holy. We know that we are peace. And we know that we are wisdom, all qualities of God. And in this moment and in this place, I claim that for us. For everyone assembled here, for all of our friends, all of our family, everyone who sees this online, I know the truth that we are expressions of oneness. There is only one force evident in our lives, and that is God, the good omnipotence. And we are chips off that block. We are made of all the good stuff. Goodness is our inheritance, and it is who and what we are. And I claim that, I know that, and I see that. I see us as the Christ. I see each individual here as the Christ, the perfection of God, and I see this community rising up as the perfection of God, changing our lives, changing our family, changing our community, and changing the world. And I claim this for us, and I know this as the truth, and so it is and shall always be. Amen.
Thank you.
Oh, Amy, Jesse, Brian. There's nothing I need to say. I mean, that song says it all. And I'll apologize for this. Suzanne said I look like a school marm coming up here to teach a class. I don't mean to look like that. It's just, you know, I need a little extra support sometimes. Anyway, as Suzanne said, my name is Jeannine Hedberg, and I'm a licensed Unity teacher here at Unity of Naples. And it's my absolute joy to be part of the spiritual leadership team here at Unity, and it's my absolute fantastic joy to be able to talk with you this morning about one of my favorite topics. All this month, we're talking about insight and wisdom, and it's one of the 12 powers that Charles Fillmore talked about, started writing about it probably in the 30s. And he used to call this power judgment. We've kind of stepped away from judgment. It's got some bad aura around the world, around the word, kind of with all the TV shows about judges and choosing things. So we use different words right now to describe this wonderful power that we have, this absolute glorious way that we have to approach solving challenges, getting answers in our lives. And I have to tell you, I didn't make it to the concert last night. I absolutely love Jody and Glenn and Lalo. I mean, I wanted to come so badly, and I was just so tired. I said, you know what, if I'm going to have anything good to say this morning, I better go home and go to bed. So I did that, but I missed a wonderful concert. I saw it last year, and it's just great. But it's been a really rough week at work. I don't know if any of you have had a rough week, but I don't know if it's the spring equinox coming. I don't know if it's the full moon coming. I don't know what it is, but it's been a really rough week. And what that means is I get really busy, and I forget to do my spiritual practice. I stop meditating. Oh, it'll be okay. I've meditated last week. I don't pray. Well, you know, I did. I prayed last week. You know, that should be enough. I just don't have the time right now. And what that manifests in my life is that I have a tough week. Because when I do my spiritual practice and I use the tools that we talk about here, those things that made it a tough week for me are just like little bumps in the road that I have tools and techniques to get through them. So now I'm learning one more time after how many years have I been here in Unity that I need to do my practice. I need to sit in meditation. I need to pray. I need to sit with questions and get the answers from insight, the answers from God, the good omnipotence in my life. So anyway, I was awake this morning. You'll love this. I was awake this morning at 3 minutes before 2. And I'm like, why am I awake at 1:57 this morning? I was, you know, I knew I had to do this, I was going to do this talk. So I said, oh, well, why don't I look at my watch and watch my watch turn to 3 o'clock? So I'm like, I'm watching my watch, and all of a sudden it was 1:59, and then it was 3 o'clock. And I'm like, oh, I better get up. I better start to practice my talk. So I didn't get up. But just as that amazing thing happened, it happened automatically. And I think it's a good metaphor for what we're talking about today. We're really talking about wisdom. Wisdom as an attribute of God. And I love to use Reverend Martilla Whitsett's book that we're studying here called Divine Audacity. She's taken Charles Fillmore's 12 powers and kind of modernized it for today's world. And what she's talking about here is that we have an inner knowing. We have an inner, just like my watch, an inner way to know what time it is, to know what's going on. And it has to do with wisdom and the use of our faculty of wisdom. And what she says, it's kind of like a jewel. And there are some facets on the jewel. And if we focus and we really rub those facets and make them shiny and use them, we'll be able to express wisdom in everything that we do. Now, the three facets of wisdom she talks about is knowledge. Yeah, we all know we need knowledge. We need book learning. We need the knowledge not to put our hand on a hot stove when we're a child. We need that knowledge, and that sits in the back of everything that we do. But knowledge is not wisdom. Knowledge is book learning. Knowledge is learning out in the world, but it's not really wisdom. Wisdom has a lot more depth to it. Some people say it's instinct, and it's not instinct. Wisdom is not instinct. All animals have instinctual needs and instinctual desires, but it has nothing to do with wisdom. It has to do with survival. So it's not instinct, it's knowledge, but not really knowledge. So what is wisdom? And what Reverend Martilla Whitsett said is, wisdom is applied knowledge. So we've taken all that knowledge we have in our lives and we're applying it to a situation. And she has these three facets to kind of look at. The first one is what we used to call judgment, and she calls it mental evaluation or assessment. And I think that's a good way to step away from what some people feel that judgment is a bad word. And there are no really bad words in the world. So judgment, another way to look at it is assessment. If we're assessing something, we're looking at two options and seeing where we want to choose the answer to what we're asking. So the second facet is spiritual discernment. And discernment is sensing without judging. So it's having this place within ourselves where we can sense an answer and not judge it. And it could be something as simple as, well, I would never thought of that before. Or it could be something, yeah, I've been thinking about that for a long time. But it, you know, I've been judging it. It's not the direction I need to go. But what it is being able to take all of the input coming through the world into us and sensing a direction without judging it, saying, Spirit is asking me to do something. Let me just take a walk down that path, even though I don't totally understand it. So that's a part of what wisdom is. And the third part she talks about, which is my favorite part, is intuition. And intuition is a tool that we can all develop if we haven't developed it. I don't know if any of you remember Shakti Gawain. Back in the 70s, I mean, I bought this when I was in college, and trying to learn to develop my intuition. And she's got a second book out called Developing Intuition with some really great exercises in it. But we've been talking about intuition for a long time. And Reverend Martilla Wetzet really says intuition is the largest part of wisdom. And if we can develop our muscle, it's not a muscle, but if we can develop our ability with intuition, we will be able to use wisdom to help govern our lives. Now, the wisest person I know in the Bible, you could say it's Jesus, and it probably is Jesus, but historically, and what I learned in third grade, is that King Solomon was the wisest man in the Bible. And there are really two stories about Solomon that speak to the use of wisdom. And the first comes from 1 Kings. When Solomon was a new king, Solomon's father was King David, and King David had passed, and they made Solomon the king when he was a young man. And in 1 Kings 3, God is asking Solomon, what should I give you? What would you like to be a better king? And he says, you have made your servant king in place of my father David, although I am only a little child. I do not know how to come out or go in. And your servant is in the midst of people whom you have chosen, a great people, so numerous they cannot be numbered or counted. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding mind to govern your people, able to discern between good and evil, for who can govern this, your great people? And that was the first lesson I learned. I think it was third grade, to ask for a discerning mind. He didn't ask for riches. He didn't ask for lots of wives. He didn't ask for lots of cattle. He asked for understanding, wisdom. And he was a young man, and God gave that to him, along with everything else that Solomon had. Now, in unity, we look at a metaphysical interpretation of the stories in the Bible. We believe that they happened. They were written about by people inspired as aspects of God. And we look at the story of Solomon as a story within ourselves. Solomon is a part of us. And the word Solomon, S-O-L, is the first part of his name. It's the same base as solar. It means sun. It means brightness. It means that beautiful yellow color. It means sun man. I like to say sun human. So we can all identify with Solomon and the wisdom that Solomon has. And when Solomon talks about ruling all of the people of Israel, those are our thoughts. So how we use wisdom to rule over all of our thoughts is what this whole process is about. It's an easy process. It's three steps, three parts. Easy. It's not hard. We just have to keep doing it every day. So the second story that we all learned is also in 1 Kings, and it's the story of the two women and the two babies. And I don't know if you remember that story, but there were two women who had each had a baby about the same time. They were living together, and one woman's baby died during the night, and she switched the babies and took the living baby, and they went before King Solomon and said, well, that's my baby, and that's my, you know, so they had this argument. And so Solomon, using his faculty of wisdom, understanding, discernment, said, okay, guys, bring me a sword. And they brought a sword before the king. And the king said, divide the living boy in two, then give half to one and half to the other. But the woman whose son was alive said to the king, because compassion for her son burned within her, please, my lord, give her the living boy. Certainly do not kill him. That is the type of discernment we're talking about. I'm so sorry about this, but anyway, that's the type of discernment that we're asking for here. We all have challenges in our lives. Challenges that in the olden days, I used to take a piece of paper, pros and cons, and write these pros and cons, and if I had more cons, I wouldn't do it. If I had more pros, I would probably do it. The cons may still win out. And that's a use of knowledge. It's not a use of wisdom. It's not a use of discernment. And it's not a use of intuition. Now, it's still a tool. Well, I think we all use that as a tool. But it is not the depth of what we're talking about here, the depth of what wisdom, which is a faculty of God. It's one of the God characteristics that we can embrace, that we have within us. And when we can embrace that as one of our 12 powers, it leads us along the spiritual path, solving challenges that come into our lives. Now, Charles Fillmore was ahead of his time. He wrote in the 30s, into the early 40s, this wonderful book called The 12 Powers. And he actually took it one step farther than calling the 12 powers the 12 disciples. He actually had 12 areas in the body they related to. And this was back in the 30s. He was talking about all the nerves at your stomach, at your where your aorta goes in your stomach. And we talk about having a feeling in the pit of our stomach. We talk about a second brain, that our gut is really, science now is saying it's our second brain. And back in the 30s and before, Charles was writing about how wisdom, this is the seat of wisdom. The color of wisdom is yellow, and it sits in our solar plexus. And so those gut feelings, that second brain, that's our gut, that feeling in the pit of our stomach, all those things that have been happening for years and years and years relate to this use of wisdom. And you can tell that what the title of the talk today is an inner knowing, and it's an inner job. We're not talking about anything happening outside of us, looking for answers outside of us. These are all things within ourselves. It is an inner knowing. It is an inner knowledge, an inner peace, an inner love, an inner wisdom that we bring forth into every decision we have. Where am I going to go to dinner tonight? Something as simple as that? Or am I going to move? Am I going to marry someone? Am I going to have a child? All of those questions we're able to answer by using these really great skills. And the three facets. The first one is mental evaluation. And that's really using sound judgment. And you can use comparisons, you know, just like that list. You can use those comparisons. And so we use sound judgment. And you can step away and call it sound assessment of what's going on in your life. But it really is assessing. And we assess with knowledge, we assess with experiences, and we assess with inspiration, what we feel inside. And what we feel impacts what we do. I was telling someone a story that my mom used to tell me every day, I think. Jeannine, whether you believe it's true, whether you believe you can do it or you believe you can't, either way, you're right. And I was telling someone that story, and it was like I hadn't thought of that in years. But that's an aspect of what we're talking about here. Our beliefs, how we feel about something, what our heart tells us to do is a piece of what we will accomplish and what we'll do in the world. And so that's a facet of wisdom. Now, the black and white decisions we kind of talked about already, but your life can be on a notepad. It can be in a journal, and we can make these choices by writing. We can also do it just by sitting with a problem. Reverend Martillo Whitsitt says, just sit with a problem. Sit with it. Let it percolate. Let it sit underneath everything that you're doing every day. And that answer will come forth out of intuition, out of wisdom, out of the guidance of your heart, out of God as love in our life. And so rushing to decisions is not what we're talking about here. We're talking about using all of our faculties to come up with really great decisions. Now, the second facet that we're talking about of wisdom is called discernment. And some people will say discernment's a type of judgment, but Reverend Martillo Whitsitt really makes the point that it's not. What she calls it is, it is a type of perception, and it's sensing without judging. So we can sense that we like a red dress in a store without judging it against other red dresses. We can say, I really like that dress. We can do the same with food. We can do the same with social situations. We can do the same with a vacation. We can sense what we feel is the right direction to go. So along with, this is a discernment, which is different than, with using a spiritual evaluation. So now we're discerning without the checklists. We're feeling, and then the next step is going to be we're going to intuit. So she really talks about, at this step, using discernment, we're going to rely on principle. And she talks about sitting in the silence, all of the spiritual practices, sitting in the silence, praying, reading spiritual literature, asking a question and sitting with it in meditation. All of the spiritual practices that I walked away from last week and had a little bit of a rough week, when we do these practices daily and add other practices in, I'm sure Amy and Jesse play music and it's meditative. I know that Sandra writes in her journal every day and does wonderful things and experiences wonderful things. I've never been able to commit to that, but I'm working at it. We all have other pieces of a practice that when we do it, it leads us into absolutely glory. It leads us to a God life, a good life, a life based on love. All right, so that third part that we're talking about is intuition. And intuition is really a gut feeling. And it's our birthright. It's something that is within us at all times. We were born with it, and you can look at children. Children often know what they want right there. They have that intuition within them. And I grew up in a family where I was going to be a scientist. And so for me, knowledge was going to be it. I was studying, and I was going to classes. And so the black and white of science overruled intuition. And what I found through Unity and through teachings here is that intuition is actually more valuable than knowledge. And when I can use my intuition, when I can sit into it and listen to my intuition, again, not judge it, listen and move down a path, then we have all three facets of wisdom operating together. And that's really all we're asking for here. Use wisdom as one of your 12 powers. Use wisdom as you go throughout your day. Use these facets of wisdom to make decisions. And the decisions will come from a God-based place, a place based on love, based on peace, based on perfection. And that's where, if all of our decisions can come from that place, I believe that that inner knowing, that inner knowledge will make us happy, well, living as the perfection of God, living as what we call in Unity the Christ, creating heaven on earth in every moment. And that's what I ask for everyone. Use this power, use this inner knowing. I'd like to invite Amy and Jesse to come on back up. We're going to do just a short meditation. And for any of you who do meditations, sometimes there's a chakra meditation that you can do. Each chakra has different colors. The chakra we're talking about here is the solar plexus chakra. Its color is yellow. And so I really want to think about that sunny, lemony yellow as we go into meditation and bringing that into your solar plexus. So Amy and Jesse, go ahead.
Take me to green pastures, lay me by still waters, back to the beginning, deep within my soul. Plant me in the meadow, shower me with sunlight, lift me up from under, teach me how to go. All is well, all is well. Listen to the Spirit whisper.
Take a deep, deep cleansing breath together as a community. Let it out. And take a moment and picture the sun. Picture lemony, yellow, bright sun as we're going towards spring season here in Florida. Picture that yellow sitting right at your solar plexus, right at your tummy, warming your whole body. And know the truth, hold the truth that I am wisdom. I am wisdom. I am the God quality wisdom. The decisions I make come from this place of wisdom. The choices I make come from this place of wisdom. My wholeness, my prosperity, my joy, my peace come from this place of wisdom. And now take that bright yellow sun and let it just come through your whole body and come out of your body and embrace this whole community and this whole county and this whole world, and know that we are the light of God. This light shining from us, as the wisdom of God.
All is well.
All is well, and so it is and shall always be. Amen and amen. Thank you so much, Amy, Jesse. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. And we've come to this time in our service when, from our place of wisdom and intuition and love and peace and passion and all the attributes of God, we ask for you to help support this community. I'd like to ask the ushers to come forward. We do have a wonderful way you can donate via text. I think that's on the board there. All donations go to help us maintain this wonderful community, these wonderful spiritual practices that we teach, the classes, the concerts. Everyone here is a volunteer. I'd like to thank especially all of our tech team. They're doing a great job today.
Now together with me, say, divine love
through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive.
Grateful I am, grateful I am grateful. Grateful I am, grateful I am grateful. My gift to you is gratitude. Oh, yes, I'm grateful. Whoa.
Gratitude with me.
Grateful I am, grateful I am grateful. Grateful I am grateful.
Oh, and can everyone stretch out their hands? We're going to bless these offerings. We bless them to do the will and the work of this marvelous community of love. We see them expanding and multiplying like flocks of eagles going out to do their good works. And we know this is true. And in gratitude, we say, thank you. And so it is. Amen. All right, I'd like to ask one more favor. We have a wonderful group of volunteers in this community called the Prayer Chaplains. I'd like to close out service with a bit of prayer and have the prayer chaplains help me here. If all the prayer chaplains would stand, it would be absolutely marvelous. We have our wonderful leader here. Reverend Eileen is the leader of the prayer chaplains, and we are so thrilled to have her here and have her leading the chaplains. We have a wonderful new book we're studying, and the chaplains are available for prayer after service. We have two places set up in each corner. If a circular building could have quarters, those two are the corners. And we'll have our prayer chaplains there to help you celebrate answered prayer or to do a prayer with you. So please, let's come together and know the truth. Know the truth of who and what we are. We are blessed beyond measure. We are God incarnate on this earth plane. We are the wisdom of God, the love of God, the peace, the passion, and the joy of God. And we bring those qualities into our lives and live as the Christ in this world. And I know this as the truth. I know this as the only truth. And so it is and shall always be. Amen and amen.
And with that energy, the energy of that beautiful service, the beautiful message and music, we invite you all to rise up as we close in song. A reminder, if you are an active member, join us back in the sanctuary in a little under an hour for our annual meeting. Let's close out with Let There Be Peace on Earth.
Together we say, the light of God surrounds us, the love of God enfolds us, the power of God protects us, the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well.